Hey everyone, today we're going to talk about a tool that I use all the time when I'm planning out different courses or even my blog videos, and we will walk you through everything that I do inside of this tool and how it can help you as well. So let's go ahead and get started. If you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts, including tips and tricks on Camtasia, Articulate Storyline, Rise, as well as different audio tips and tricks and augmented reality. You can also grab templates on Articulate Storyline 360 and XAPI templates. And then you could check out full courses, everything you need to know from A to Z on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. Now, I get asked a lot how I prep my courses, and this could be anything from just even a blog post to a full course on Udemy or Pluralsight, and how I kind of go through that process. So I wanted to walk you through that process here and talk about a tool that I often use, and this is kind of my brain when I'm mapping out different things or even my blog posts. And I start to map them out and I start to outline them and I start to organize them using a tool called Trello. Now, Trello is a common tool. Often people have used it for project management. I use it more so for these different courses and different videos that I create. And then I could track the progress of them if I wanted to, and I could grab different things and adjust different things right inside of Trello. So I'm gonna walk you through an example course that I'm creating at the moment. And then I'm gonna walk you through how I use with my blog posts, and then even how I go in and I use Trello to log different issues for issues that I found, and something called Apple Shortcuts that allows me to kind of speed up my process a lot quicker. So just more of a kind of a thought process or how I use this tool. So hopefully it gives you some ideas of how you can use it as well. So the first one that I want to talk about is how I start to organize my different courses. So when I come into Trello, you can come in and create a list just by coming in and adding a sample like title or something like that. And that will add a list. So you start to organize the list, and then you can go in and add a card and just hit enter. So as simple as that, you can have just an organization of cards and lists. Now what I do when I'm creating this course, for example, is I come in and I start to organize the list by my different modules. What are the main overall flows that I want to talk about? Okay, so the first one is we're gonna be talking about dissecting the XAPI statement in this case. We're gonna be talking about the potential of XAPI. So I get that overall flow in those different important areas that's outlined first. And then I start to come in and outline the different topics that may be inside of there. So you can see right here, here's my different topics. If I click on the card, then I haven't done this yet for this course specifically, but I use the description to detail out different things that I want to cover inside of this section. So I can simply just add some bullet points. So one size doesn't fit all. We're gonna talk about personalization inside of this video. So I'll type in personalization. Then we'll talk about how most of our, in this day, we're pushing content rather than pulling content. We'll cover push rather than pull. So that's what I start to do, is I start to outline, I start to think through it. Okay, what do I want to cover in this video? But each card is going to become a video inside of this course. Now I can also come in here and add on different checklists. So these checklists could be production, for example. And in the production, I could have outline. I'm going to create an outline for this video specifically. I'm going to have recorded. So I come in here and say this one has been recorded, or I can have edited as well. And then as I start to make progress on this specific video, I could come in and say, okay, outline is done. And now it has a progress for how much more I have to do here. So this is just a great way to keep track of this specific video inside of this specific topic. But one thing that I really love about it is the fact that I can just drag and drop and reorganize. And as my thought process starts to take shape here, I can come in here and say, oh, that one probably would be better if we did it before this. So that's my thought process and how I use Trello for courses. The next thing is my blog post, and you can see all the different blog posts that I have. And this one I use more kind of like Kanban, where I have like, you know, a backlog of different videos that I could do. Then I have, okay, what am I currently planning? What do I have up next? What's in production as well? So right here, Trello for storyboarding, I can just go ahead and move this over into up next. I can click on it and I have a description of what I want to cover in that video. And which is pretty cool because as I start to have more ideas, I can go in and just kind of add those to Trello. Now, one thing I also do is I add shortcuts. So I use the Apple shortcuts, and you can get into this by just typing in shortcuts here. And this will have your different shortcuts that you can create here. And so if you click on add, you can create different shortcuts. Now, if you have the Trello app installed on your phone, and this is iOS only, I do have to say that, but if you have Trello on your phone, you could go ahead and create these different shortcuts. Now, this shortcut right here allows me to add a blog post. So I just tap on it. If I get an idea for a blog post, for example, it will pop open with just a text entry box. I can go ahead and just say sample, and then it will add it to my Trello board. So in a second, it might be down at the bottom or at the top here, but it will add a sample to the top of my blog post there. So that is another way. If I'm just, you know, out and about, I want to capture a blog idea, then I could just quickly tap on this and submit it that way as well. Another thing that I do, and this is more for my day job here, I'm gonna go ahead and switch over to here. And there is this issue tracker that I want to go in and I want to add an issue. So I found something that isn't quite working. Then I could go ahead and click on track issue, and it will pop open. You can even have like a series of things pop open. So in this case, I want to add the title, not working, and then hit done. It will pop open, which course are you talking about? I'll select the course. Then I can come in here and describe the issue. And this one I could be as detailed as I want, click on done, and then it will pop open the camera. I'll take a screenshot of, or as a shot of whatever I'm working on because I'm on site here. Then I'll click on use photo, and then it will add that here. So you can see right here, not working. And in a second, the photo will actually pop up. I think the photo is still loading. There we go. There's my photo, and I have that already in my backlog. I can then prioritize it. I can move it to current, and then I can move it to testing as well, and then move it to completed once I'm done. So Trello and shortcuts allows me to just capture things really quickly, to organize things really quickly, to add bullet points to my videos, to organize my entire course as well. And so if you're not using Trello, I highly recommend it just for, if anything, just kind of fleshing out different ideas and thinking through different things as well, and capturing different things as well. So a really useful tool, and then combine that with Apple shortcuts, or if Android has a shortcuts, combine that with Trello, it just makes life a whole lot easier. So I wanted to make sure that I covered that today. If you want to check out more tips and tricks, head on over to my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts on Camtasia, Articulate Storyline, Rise 360. You can also check out different templates and download different templates on Storyline, and then also XAPI. And then you can also get full courses, everything from A to Z, on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. And soon, I will also have a course on Camtasia, everything from A to Z. That's all that I have for today. So if you liked my video, head on over to my YouTube channel, subscribe to my YouTube channel, hit that like button, but also the bell notification so you get notified of any future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel a lot so I can keep producing these for you and creating new content. And if you want to learn about something specifically, comment down below and say, hey, can you do something on this? And I read all my comments, and so I'd be happy to, anything, suggestions that you may have, I'd be happy to do those. But that's all that I have for today. So thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.